All right, welcome everyone to a short video. I want to do a real positive video on the vision of oneness right now and explain it a little better. We've had some heavy videos about the false rapture. It's very heavy stuff. Let's shift gears for right now. Vision of oneness. Here's a way to explain it that just occurred to me. What it is you literally see that everybody and everything is totally saved. Not only saved, but never was in any position of danger or loss or non-inclusion or exclusion at all. Nothing has ever been in any position of possible exclusion from the kingdom of God. It's impossible. And you literally see that. You're aware of this fact. Now, here's the kicker. You're not sure about yourself. You're not sure. But you're seeing everyone, everything and everyone else is, for sure. You see it. And then all that happens is you just abide in that awareness and say, wow, it's so wonderful to see all these blessed people and blessed things and blessed universe. It's just awesome to see this. I just love seeing this. Now, whether I am included or not, I don't know. But it's still wonderful to view all this. I feel completely blessed to be able to even see this fact. What a loving God this is, that there can be no exclusion whatsoever under any circumstances. Total safety, total security, total inclusiveness. So, and yet, I'm not sure. I don't know about me. Therein lies the greatness of the vision of oneness, is you gradually come to the conclusion, well, that maybe I'm also included. But it doesn't happen immediately. First you see everyone else, and then you say, well, it's just a gradual sort of dawning upon you as you abide in this. What you're seeing is everyone blessed, that maybe also I'm included in this. Why, if God would include everyone else and everything else without exception, effortlessly, etc., maybe I'm included too. Maybe. And this is what gradually dawns upon us. And ultimately, when we realize that, yes, we are also included in that total, the total inherent grace of reality, that's when the final step is taken, where we no longer even need perception to perceive anything. But that final step is taken by God. So the intermediate step is called the vision of oneness, where we see everyone and everything completely blessed, inherently blessed, tracelessly, residue-free, blessed by total inclusion in eternal life, the one eternal life. And we just get to see that. And it's like totally wonderful to see. Totally wonderful to see. So it's like watching an incredibly great movie, and then you think, wow, I'm so fortunate to have a ticket to watch this movie. It's the most beautiful movie possible. And then you wonder, well, maybe I'm blessed too. Even beyond being able to watch this movie. So that's how it's done. Jesus said the first will be last and the last will be first. Okay, if you want to see your blessing first, you'll be the last. If you want to see everybody else's blessing first, you'll be the first, actually, you see, because it will dawn upon you eventually that you too are blessed, and then you are truly have no more need. The continuity problem has completely vanished for you then, and you can truly realize and know the truth, directly know reality as it is. So that's what it means. The first, those who want their blessing first will be the last ones to get it. Those who want the blessing upon the rest upon everyone else first, they'll be the first ones to actually get it, that they too are blessed. It'll gradually dawn upon them. So I think this is the best explanation I have yet on the underlying how it works, how the vision of oneness works. I can't directly explain how the blessing feels to you, how you see it, because it's too deep to explain in words, actually. There's too much of sort of an amazement, a relief, and just you know, it just doesn't, it doesn't lend itself to the words, the kind of words we use that relate to happenings in the world. It's not really a happening in the world of any type. It's a realization that nothing has ever happened. In the kingdom of God, nothing has ever happened as far as our status goes. Our status has never been touched, and the very issue of could it ever be touched doesn't even arise at all. So put everyone else first, their enlightenment first, and yours last. And you will end up being, actually, you will end up having your continuity problem erode and evaporate for you. So this is the best explanation I have yet. Best explanation I have yet. And hopefully it'll resonate with a lot of you and just say, oh yeah, that is right. I never saw it before. I couldn't understand what Jesus was saying. You know, you've got to bless your brother first. Put everyone else first, their blessings, see them like that. Ah, of course. It's not, no, my enlightenment, not my blessing, my divinity. It's everybody else's. And you can see it. That's what I saw in the Vision of Oneness dawned upon. I saw everyone and everything as inherently, totally blessed without any possibility of it ever being otherwise. And I just like, wow, that's what I really want to see. I want to see everyone else blessed. You know, that's what's more important than seeing myself blessed. It's more important to see that everybody else is. Because, of course, we have doubts about everybody, don't we? We say, wow, I wonder about that one and that one and that one and that one. How is that possible? And you see that they're blessed, and then you think, well, maybe it's possible that I'm blessed if God is not excluding anyone or anything. Effortless non-exclusion. Totally, you see, just no possibility excluded. And how could we think that we're excluded? You know, that would just be silly, wouldn't it? Be silly. And so the whim of silliness gradually leaves us of its own accord. It just goes away of its own accord. We don't have to do anything to push it out. It just, you know, evaporates away. So when you see the Vision of Oneness, don't worry about yourself. Just keep viewing it. Just keep viewing it. That's what you're supposed to be seeing. If you say, well, what about me? What am I? Am I? Poof, it vanishes for you. See? Don't say, what about me? Just keep looking at it. Just keep seeing it. Just keep seeing it. Enjoy it. Just enjoy it. That's what it's all about. And people look at you and say, what are you seeing? You're seeing that everyone's blessed is what you're seeing. And so they'll look at you and say, my God, you seem so holy, you know. You said, I don't know, but I'm just seeing everybody else is holy. That's what I'm seeing. If you look at Ramana Maharshi and look in his eyes, you can just see. What are you seeing? I mean, he's just delighted at, he's seeing everything is blessed. Everyone is blessed without exception. And that lights up the face. It lights up the eyes. It's like the most wonderful thing to see. Nobody can exclude themselves from reality. It's impossible. And so that is the smile on the face of the saint. The smile is, they're seeing this, and they say, this is the greatest thing imaginable. This is the greatest thing possible. I was worried about all my brothers and sisters. I was concerned, and now I see there's no reason to be worried about them whatsoever. None whatsoever. So it's a huge, huge, huge relief. Because even if you saw yourself as blessed, you would say, well, what about everybody else? It's more important to see everybody else first. You take care of that first, and then you as last. If you did you first and then everybody else, you know, then that would be so difficult, right? Say, yeah, I'm blessed, but I don't know about everybody else. No, say, first see everybody else is blessed. And then you'll say, you know what? Hey, I'm probably blessed too by God. So it's easy. That's the way. That's the way. That's what I saw. That's what I glimpsed. And this is what I'm is being clarified for me now by the Holy Spirit. Okay, we'll keep this one short. And I'm sorry about all those heavy videos, but I believe it's necessary just so we are wise. You see, we got to be wiser than the serpent, right? And the serpent is up to some very serpentine activity in this world, for sure. So we're just wise, we're aware of what's going on, and then we get back to the vision of oneness, which is to see everyone as equally blessed. Everything equally blessed. Equal blessing rests upon all. Just view that. And then eventually you'll conclude that it must rest upon you also. But don't struggle with that issue. That will just dawn upon you organically as you see everything, everyone is equally blessed. All right? Give that some consideration. Okay, that's it.